Hey, Bart Miller with Cycling Strong. So, what shoe should you wear? That's the big question today. So, if you're going to be on a mountain bike, a couple things you want to think about. Are you going to go clipless, which means a flat pedal, or are you going to clip in? If you're going to go clipless, then I would suggest you use a shoe more like this with a really grippy sole. There's lots of them out there, but they're a little more flexible, but they have really good grip to grab the pedal. Super important. Also, you can go with a shoe like this and have a clip on it. You'll see right there in the bottom. Now, when you have a clip like that, it's easy to clip in and out, but it gives you the versatility of a shoe that can do both. It can actually ride a regular flat pedal and give you clipped in, clipped out, and walk when you go out to do things on a mountain bike. Great option. But a lot of flexibility in this, so I wouldn't say this is a shoe to race in unless you're going to go downhill. Now, also in the mountain biking category, you can go to a shoe like this. If you see the bottom of this shoe, you'll see that you can still get off, run, do everything you need to, walk, stuff like that with this shoe, but this shoe is going to be a lot more rigid. It's not going to give you any give, so it's going to be a lot more pedal effective when you're using your pedal stroke in a race. So more long distance type of stuff, this is the shoe you want to be in on a mountain bike, okay? And now we're gonna get into some road biking shoes now, because not everybody that's looking for what cycling shoe to wear obviously is riding a mountain bike. So if you're riding a road bike in town and you're just messing around, let's go to a shoe like this, a soft-soled shoe you can ride around in. But if you're trying to do some really more intensive exercise and you're going, let's just say, 10 to 20 miles, I would suggest that you go to a stiffer soled shoe. Now, the reason being is you get all the power to the pedal because it's like a ski boot, if you want to use it in reference. There's no way the power can escape through the bend of the shoe. All power goes in this type of shoe right to the pedal, which is what you want. Makes your pedal more efficient, your pedal stroke, I should say, more efficient. Now, this shoe here is a higher end shoe. So if you look at this shoe closely, you'll see that this is carbon fiber. Now, if you're not on a budget that you want to invest that kind of money in a shoe, that's okay. The only reason that I went with this kind of shoe is it's super, super light and effective, okay? So I get the best of both worlds. You just need a really good stiff shoe if you're a beginner cyclist and you don't want to invest that kind of money. Now, there's different types of soles you can look at. So this is a stiff sole here, carbon fiber once again. Has a ratchet system on the side. Now, the reason that the ratchet system is nice on this is I can make super small incremental changes while I'm on my bike if the shoe is a little tight or not tight enough. Where this shoe here, I have to use the Velcro to make that happen. It's a little tougher to do that on. Even though both are awesome shoes, I like both. These guys, you know, Physique's always made a phenomenal shoe. CD, they've always been my love, not gonna lie, I've always rode this shoe. But CD, you know, I love how the ratchet system, which is the BOA system, now it's out on a lot more shoes, so great shoe. But let's go to something like this. If you wanna be badass on your bike, still have all the carbon fiber, still have everything on a shoe, but you wanna look really cool, you go to this really epic lace-up shoe. Now, I just love it because it looks way cool on the bike, it's phenomenal, it gives you the ability to just, I don't know, lace it up, pretty awesome. But I will tell you, if you decide to use a lace-up shoe, make sure you use a runner's knot in that shoe, so if this happens by chance to come undone, you don't lose everything, you're able to get stopped, pulled over. What I mean by undone is this comes loose from being tied. You're still tight enough that you don't, it doesn't just come really instantly loose on you. You have time to get off, get that type of thing re-tightened back up. So make sure you use a runner's knot. But on the road bike, super important to have a really good clipped in shoe. Unless you're just riding around town, I would suggest clipping in, and I would get a really stiff soled shoe like this to be able to get the power to the pedal. So I hope that answers your question of what cycling shoe and why you should use a cycling shoe when you're out riding your bike. Keep out there, keep cycling strong. Yeah, you gotta love being on a bike.